Championship Fighting Alliance number 3, and it all begins right now.
Next fight up, fighting out of Minnesota, Quebec, Canada, with a record of 4-0, standing 5'9" tall, fighting out of the red corner, Jordan Pretty Boy Parson, 145 even. And his opponent, making his professional debut, standing at 5'7" tall, fighting out of the blue corner, James Thunder Polodna, 144.5, awesome.
Entering the cage first, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist standing 5'9" tall. Weighing in 145 pounds, he brings a record standing 4 victories and no defeats. From Brooklyn Center, Minnesota, here is Pretty Boy, Jordan Parson. And his opponent tonight, fighting out of the blue corner, a Muay Thai fighter standing 5'7" tall. He too weighed in 145 pounds, and tonight makes his professional debut, hailing from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Here is James Thunder Polodna! Referee in charge of the action inside the cage, Troy Wong.
Underway.
Wrestling against Muay Thai, very nice.
Polodna in the yellow and black, Parsons in the black and white. Parsons lists Muay Thai as his stand-up discipline as well. Not intimidated about the Muay Thai pedigree that Polodna brings into the cage.
It's a pretty impressive knockout record.
He's got 2 world titles, in Muay Thai, the WPMF and the WPMO titles. And he said, Parsons will not be able to take me down, and if he does, he won't keep me down long. Been working his takedown defense, and he's been working getting back up to his feet on the takedown.
Nice low leg kick, James Polodna. Nice high kick, he's bringing in that Muay Thai now. Shuffle kick, high to the head, blocked by Jordan.
Dancing with his hands down, already feeling confident.
Lunging right hook by James Polodna, misses.
Parson, the younger of the two, at 21 years old.
That was a nice front round kick, a tap there. Definitely feels comfortable with his kicks.
Parsons has a good amount of AMI experience. He's got a good record as an amateur as well, 13-1, and he's got an outstanding record as a pro. He's undefeated, 5-0. So not intimidated in any aspect of the game. Oh, he clipped Parsons. He tripped over the side of the cage, and he still clipped Parsons on the way in.
That's what happens. He clipped him. Nice right hook, stunned him. Now we got a body lock here by Parsons. Let's see what happens here. Trips him. Nice takedown.
There's that wrestling. Now we're going to see Polodna said he will not be able to keep me down.
Polodna in the half guard of Jordan right now. Let's see what he can do from his back. Jordan Parsons trying to push off of that left leg of James Polodna, trying to pass that guard.
James Polodna said he's been working his BJJ over at the TriStar gym under Faraz Zahabi.
Inside control right now, and he mounts.
Nice mount for Parsons.
Trying to keep his opponent down, raining down punches now as Parsons.
That arm fed up. Polodna fed him the arm, but Parsons decided not to shoot the arm bar. Instead, he's going to try to rain down some more punishment.
Well, I'll tell you one thing right now. He's got to be careful with that right hand, because if Parsons grabs that right hand, he can grab that arm triangle. Got him pinned up against the cage. Not a lot he can do there. Can't really fall back for an armbar. There he can. He's kind of on the side. Raining down elbows. Feels comfortable here.
Yeah, Parsons feels real comfortable from this position. You can see he puts his hooks in at will. Decides when he's going to posture up. Decides when he's going to tighten up. Right now, you see Polodna just holding on for dear life, trying to keep him from posturing up.
Giving that right arm up. He's got to be careful. Every time he comes off to his side, he's giving that right arm up for an arm bar.
This is Polodna's MMA debut. And obviously, two different sports. And he does not look like he has an answer for this ground and pound that Jordan Parsons is applying right now.
Someone's been split. I think it's the left eyebrow of Polodna. He got caught with an elbow on the way down.
And that right elbow of Parsons is nasty. There goes the armbar setup right there. It's there for the taking, but Parsons, there he goes. Finally decides mercifully to take it. Nice scramble there by Polodna.
Very, very smart fight here by Jordan Parsons. Very, very nice. He going. Had a decent knee bar there to work. I just think it's the lack of jiu-jitsu on James Polodna.
Right now, Parsons grinding that left elbow into the left head, of left side of the head of Polodna. And that is the end of round one. We're gonna take a close look at that eye of Polodna because it's bleeding pretty good right now.
Right above the eyebrow. Let's see, as long as it's not obstructing his vision.
You got commercials here?
And when we come back, it's round number two. Stay with us.
So Sorry about that, Jay. All right. We got commercial height. How are you? Hey. I got a question for you.
Yeah.
I'm going to go do cover the Pan Am Games on Wednesday.
Okay.
Are you up on the judo scene here? Or you're from the American athletes or wrestling or who's going to be down there or anything like that? That's
no,
not your thing, right?
That's not my thing.
Yeah, I need to, because I've got to cover for like 30 sports. You know, we're going to be on air 12 hours a day. So.
You need help? What do you want, TV coverage?
Huh?
What do you want, TV coverage?
No. I'm going to be doing the TV coverage.
Oh, okay.
But I just...
You got a network?
C-F-A.
Number two underway here in Miami.
Nice jab cross combo there by Polodna.
They did a great job in the corner of James Polodna with that cut. Our doctors here today, Robert Boltic and Jerome Obed, did a good job with the that's finally opened up again, but boy, it's tough when it cuts that deep.
Looks like it's streaming down the side of the cheek. It's really not obstructing the vision, which is a good thing. And I wonder if Parson's corner has told him to repeat round one and bring Polodna down to the ground, which I think would be a very, very smart game plan for him since it worked out so well for him in round one. He doesn't want to get caught by Polodna, which has some amazing. There he goes. And down goes Parson.
Wrestling 101.
Very nice. Controlling Polona's body up against the cage, raining down punches. Passes his guard.
Perfect game plan executed by Jordan Parsons. Why stand and trade with the Muay Thai stud? When you've got the wrestling pedigree, you can get the mount at will and let those elbows go. Oh, punishing fight. Punishing fight.
Full mount right now by Jordan Parsons. And Polona, all he's doing is protecting. He's going for that arm again. He wants to finish this fight. Just has to be careful. He can't really fall back into that armbar from there.
You can see Parsons softening up Polodna, going for the armbar when needed, but he's in no rush.
Polona's going to have to push off this cage and definitely improve his position, because all he's doing is getting caught by elbows and punches here. He's got some very, very high mount, Jordan Parsons, on Polodna, which is really not allowing him to do anything with his arms but cover. He's going to have to push off that cage, roll over, and hip escape out of this position.
Parsons fighting out of the Minnesota Martial Arts Academy in Minneapolis under Greg Nelson. And Greg's got to be happy with his protege's work here so far tonight. A perfectly executed plan here in the featherweight tournament in Miami.
And it's been a spectacular fight card this evening. A lot of action in all these fights. Right now, Jordan Parsons, James Polodna having a great ground game here.
Over the halfway mark here in round number two. And it has been all Jordan Parsons. If you're just tuning in, you're watching Championship Fighting Alliance number three from the U.S. Century Bank Arena, Miami, Florida. I'm Jay Adams alongside George Rodriguez. Thanks for tuning in. This is the second fight in our tourney in the featherweight division. Later on tonight, the second round of our lightweight tournament. All undefeated fighters left in the lightweight tournament.
Both fighters back up to their feet.
Troy wants to make sure that Polodna is okay. Fight time is back in on the clock. Jordan Parsons feeling very confident. Oh, one of the photographers here, Cage, I just showed me a close-up of the gash on the left eyebrow of James Polodna. It is deep. Looks like a horror movie. Jordan Parsons clearly comfortable. See him wading in at will now. He knows he's got the takedown if needed.
Absolutely. Polodna needs to circle off to his blind side and keep this fight in the center of the cage where he can avoid Jordan Parsons shooting takedown. Now he gets him up against the cage, double leg takedown, and back on the canvas. Just a repetition of this movement. His wrestling's outstanding. Raining down punches here from the full guard.
Polodna needing to circle, needs to get on his bike, circle away from the shot, circle away from the power of Parsons. Circle, get the hands busy.
Parsons really working that cut, boy, raking that elbow in there.
Working that right elbow on the side.
And we got a great view of that right here, right next to the cage. It's great to see these guys work this hard. Polodna's gonna have to do something to improve his position from here.
Letting the hands go is the Minnesota Martial Arts Academy fighter, Jordan Parsons. And another round goes into the record books for Jordan. When we come back, it's the third and final round. Can James Polodna turn this thing around? Will the fight be stopped? We'll find out when we come back in just a couple of minutes. Stay tuned.
Well, we got some blood today, that's good.
Nice shot, look at that.
Kind of deep, right?
No, cut deep.
De cara a la morenita también.
Everybody to the US Century Bank Arena, Miami, Florida. Jay Adams alongside George Rodriguez. There's a good look right there. James Polodna does not have the same stance that Jordan Parsons had. Jordan Parsons was slamming his chest like a gorilla saying, let's go, let's go. Clearly, Jordan Parsons is feeling the mojo right now. Polodna has not been able to get things going. Can't get started. He's having trouble getting the hands going. He's got to circle away from Parsons' power. He's got to get on his bicycle. He's got to use that great Muay Thai record. Maybe some dirty boxing.
Jordan Parsons working that double leg takedown again, brings James Polodna back down against the cage, presses him up against the cage, and is trying to improve his position. Raining down punches from the full guard. Trying to obstruct the breathing.
And James Polodna, there's no hip outs. It, below the hip is very static. It's not fair to call it lay and pray because he's active, but he doesn't have an answer for this. He keeps feeding Jordan the arm, and Jordan doesn't want the arm. I think he's enjoying the beatdown.
Trying to set up that guillotine and throwing knees to the body. Smart. He knows his opponent's down. He can't throw any real crazy knees right now, and he's going for a standing guillotine. Standing guillotine. He's got to arc his body up in order for that to work out for him. There he goes, and he's arcing. Standing guillotine. Does he have it sunk in?
Polodna's got one wrist, so it's hard to tell how deep it is. Tough to tell from this angle.
Working his knees, very nice.
And Polodna able to strip off the one arm, but cannot stop the takedown. Going for the arm though, Polodna. This would be pulling a rabbit out of the hat if he could pull off this Kimura. Going for the Kimura. He's going for it. Oh, this would be an amazing rabbit out of the hat.
He's got it because he brings it back. All he has to do is go into S mount, and he lost it. But
wow,
he still has his back.
He's got the back of Jordan. Jordan shrimping out the back. Nice job there by Parsons to get back into the full closed guard. And now that welt, that cut is turning into a welt. It's starting to get nasty as Jordan zeroes in on it like a big fat target mark.
Jordan's been very smart working that cut. It wasn't that bad in the first round. He's been raking it. He's been working it. It's definitely swelling up. And great reversal there by Jordan Parson to get out of what I like to say is the only thing that I've seen James Polodna really do today, especially on the ground. Looked like he had that Kimura sunk in, and all of a sudden, Jordan Parson just snug himself out of it.
Working the side of that face. Jordan is relentless. Two minutes to go in the fight. Can Polodna pull a rabbit out of the hat?
We thought he could have, he was gonna do that a little while ago. Let's see. Jordan Parson is just fighting a perfect fight right now.
We're gonna take, that's a stand up. Okay, I thought that Troy was gonna take a look at the cut. But it's just a stand up. He was not happy with the action or lack thereof.
James Polodna now staying more in the center of the ring, picking and choosing his shots. Let's see if he can do something from there. Every time he comes back towards the cage, he gets shot in and double leg takedown.
Polodna's got nothing to lose at this point. He's got to just let him go.
Let those hands fly and let everything in the cage go right now.
He's buried on the scorecard, and he's got a cut where the fight could be stopped at any time. Let hands fly. That's your only chance at this point of winning this fight.
Absolutely. He's got to be careful. He is a Muay Thai practitioner, throwing his kicks and getting one of those kicks caught and get taken back down to the ground, but he's got to let his hands fly.
It is absolutely, oh, missing their uppercut as Jordan goes low, gets the hips below Polodna's and gets the double leg. The story of this fight, the double leg or the single leg at will.
Yep, establishes his side control again. Trying to get knee and belly, lets it go.
Jordan Parsons with the nice sprawl.
Oh, it looks like we're going for a anaconda here. Will he roll into it? Anaconda choke. He's got to pull his hips back a little bit to sink that in.
What's the defense for Polodna?
He's going to have to go ahead and continue circling into Jordan Parsons in order to alleviate that and push off the elbow with his free hand.
10 seconds to go. Polodna trying to at least take this to a decision. Jordan wants to finish.
Polodna with wrist control right now, good.
Jordan doesn't get the finish, but I think he remains undefeated nonetheless.
I would have to agree with you 100% on that, Jay. Great fight there for Jordan Parsons.
Jordan Parsons with a real beatdown of James Polodna. All right, we come back. We're going to talk with the winner of this fight. Don't forget, we still have the lightweight tourney in front of us. And that great main event, John Howard, Dennis Olsen, our co-main, Zach Chusula, Mike Rio. All that and much more on Championship Fighting Alliance.
That's good.
This way we can just come right back to the interview from the commercial. Save our voice a little. No problem.
El chamaco tiene 28 Muay Thai fights con 26 ganadas por nocao. No puedo hacer nada en el piso.
Más
no tiene lucha, no tiene piso.
Stitches.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, go to the scorecards after three rounds. All three judges have it 30-27 for your winner and still undefeated. Moving on to the semifinals, the pretty boy, Jordan Parsons.
Jordan Parsons winning this fight against James Polodna.
All right, I'm here with the winner, Jordan Parsons. Nicely done, my friend. And when you go in there with a
Muay Thai stud like Polodna, who has 26 knockouts. Why? Yeah, it's hard. Why even bother to stand up with him? Don't blame you at all when you got the wrestling pedigree you have. And now I'm going to ask you a question. There were a couple times Polodna fed you the arm. The arm bar was right there, but you opted not to take it. Were you enjoying that ground and pound?
Yeah, I was liking it a little bit, but I also didn't want to give up my position. I gave it up a couple times, and I figured he was just setting me up with the arm bar, but you never know.
That's a particularly nasty, gritty ground and pound, I might add. There were some times there where you could have postured up and laid hands on, but instead you ground the elbow in a little more. You had a really good job of zeroing in on that cut.
Yeah, I was trying to widen it up a little bit more, you know, get some blood in his eye, whatever. It's a fight. trying to hurt him as much as I can.
Well, you did that very effectively. One quick last question. You're a young guy. This is the featherweight tournament. You advance to the next round. $20,000 on the line in this featherweight tournament. What does $20,000 mean to a 21-year-old?
That means changing my life, making it so this can be what I do. I need that money. I'm tired of living how I live. Tired of being broke. Tired of it.
A lot of people don't realize what you guys go through, what you guys dedicate to come into the cage here. And I think the fans really appreciate what you go through.
It's everything to me. Everything. I made it all the way down to 145. They said I couldn't do it. They said I can't win the money. I'm going to take it. It's mine.
I like that attitude. Give it up for the pretty boy one more time. Justin Parsons.